Hello everyone, welcome to this session on moment of inertia for the triangular section. So here we'll consider a right angle triangle, and dimension of this particular right angle triangle shall be considered base B and height of the triangle as h. Consider this particular triangle to be placed in x and y plane. Preferably all the distances shall be measured along the positive x direction and positive y direction. For that reason, the section will be placed in the x and y quadrant. That is, in first quadrant, all distances shall be measured along the positive x direction and positive y direction. A small recap of what will be the centroid of the triangular section, which we had derived during the session pertaining to centroid. So, centroid of this particular triangular section along the x direction from the 90 degrees angle, it will be at a distance of b by 3. Along the height, it will be at a distance of h by 3. Comparing both the diagram, here we have considered x and y axis, which is nothing but a global x and y axis. And other section, we also have a centroid, we also have an axis which passes through the centroid. And that particular axis, we call it as xg and yg. It is all dependent upon to which particular axis it is parallel to. If I have an axis which passes through the centroid and parallel to x direction, I shall call it as xg. Similarly, if the axis passes through the centroid and parallel to y direction, we shall call it as yg. So, for that reason, we shall have two referential axes now. One is x-axis, other one is xg and yg. First, we shall try to find out the value of the line ixx. Then, we shall try to find out the value of ixg. For the second case, we will try to find out the value of IYY, then the value of IYG. This procedure and step remains the same that we had adopted for to calculate the centroid for the triangular section. To calculate the centroid for the triangular section, we consider the triangle as it is. Then, consider a thin rectangular strip. The thickness of the rectangular strip will be dy, placed at a distance of y from the origin. The total height of the triangle is h. As a resultant, the remaining left out height will be h minus of y. Base of the triangle is b. Consider a section, that is x and y axis, placed at the far away location. The thickness or the width of this particular rectangular strip, if I separate, the width of the rectangular strip will be b1. The same rectangular strip, when it coincides on the x axis, b1 will be equals to b. When it touches towards the tip of the triangular section, B1 will be equal to 0. So as a resultant, B1 will have a variation along the height of the section, that is along the y direction. So which cannot be considered during the integration term. For that reason, we need to express B1 in terms of B. To make use of that, we shall make use of principle of similar triangle. Principle of similar triangle says that height of the bigger triangle is h, base of the bigger triangle is b. Likewise, height of the smaller triangle will be h minus of y divided by b1. b1 will be equals to b by h, h minus of y. This will be the expression for b1. What is the use of this particular b1? b1 expression shall be made use to calculate the area, that is elemental area. Area of the whole triangular section is half base into height. Whereas, area of the elemental strip dA will be b1 into dy. b1 value is substituted here, b by h, h minus of y into dy, which is nothing but the area of the elemental strip. This area of the elemental strip we shall consider in the calculation of the moment of inertia. Now here, which particular axis we are going to calculate, whether ixx or iyy, is all dependent upon the variable that we are going to consider. Now, variable is y here. Since y is a variable and y is perpendicular to x, so I shall calculate the value of ixx. So, ixx is equal to integration y square dA. Then, y value should have a variation. And what will be the value of y that will have a variation is, when this particular elemental strip coincides with respect to x, y value along the x direction is 0. And when it touches the y direction, that is the tip of the triangle, y value is h. So, limits of integration of y will be 0.02h. Substitute the value here, y square shall be kept as it is. dA value will be b by h, h minus of y dy. So same expression of dA shall be considered here. B by h is constant, so b by h take it outside, 0 to h, h y square minus of y cube dy. Put this whole term within the bracket. B by h, take it out, keep it as it is outside, 0 to h. Now here, I need to integrate this particular term, y square and y cube. That is, h y square, the first term, y square into y will come out to y cube. Here it will come out to y cube. And bracket it is dy. So integration of y square will be h into y cube by 3. Integration of y square will be y cube by 3. Integration of y cube will be y raised to 4 divided by 4, 0 to h. Ixx term shall be written as b by h. Substitute the value here. When I substitute the value, h into h cube will raise to h to the power of 4 divided by 3, h. When I substitute h here, it will be h cube by 3. H cube by 3 into h will raise to h to the power of 4 divided by 3. Similarly, second substitution will be h to the power of 4 minus of h to the power of 4 divided by 4. Second limit, when we substitute here, it will be 0 for the first term and 0 for the second term. So no need to express that particular value because whole value will come out to 0. Reframing this equation, b by h kept as it is. 4h raised to 4 minus 3h raised to 4 divided by 12. B by h, b h raised to 4 divided by 12. So Ixx value will be bh cube divided by 12. So moment of inertia value line along the x direction will be, for triangular section it will be bh cube divided by 12. That is, for this particular axis it is bh cube divided by 12. Solution is not at over because I have calculated the value of bh cube by 12. In fact, I require the value of xg. As xg and xx are both parallel to each other, we shall make use of parallel axis theorem. And parallel axis theorem says is, Ixx is equal to Ixg plus a into h square. I shall redraw the triangle again here. Area of the triangle here is half base into height. Ixx value that we have calculated here is bh cube by 12. Ixg value needs to be calculated, which is axis which passes through the centroid. Xx value is bh cube by 12. Area of the triangle is half base into height. Now distance between both the line, that is xg and xx, will be called as h. And distance between both the line is h by 3, that is what is centroid distance that we had just now recalled, that is in the previous session of the centroid, which is h by 3. Substitute the value of h as h by 3, the whole square. Bh cube by 12 is equal to Ixg plus of half base into height, bh square, h will be h square, 9, square will be 9, 3, 3, 0 will be 9. Ixg will be expressed as bh cube divided by 12, kept on the left hand side, minus of this term bh into h square, which will be bh cube. Denominator, 2 into 9 will come as 18. Ixg will be 18 bh cube cross multiply 18 bh cube minus 12 bh cube divided by 12 into 18. 18 minus 12 will be 6 bh cube divided by 12 into 18. 6 ones are 6 twos are, and Ixg value will be 2 into 18 will come out 36. So Ixg value will be bh cube by 36, which means value of the moment of inertia which passes through the centroid along the x direction is bh cube by 36. If I draw the triangle again, x axis value is bh cube by 12 And xj value which passes through the centroid will be bh cube by 36. Now, whenever we solve a triangle problem, whenever we come across to solve for moment of inertia for a triangular section, we shall consider the moment of inertia of the IXX as bh cube by 36. So, this is the expression for moment of inertia value for the triangular section which passes through the centroid is bh cube by 36. Further, we need to find out the moment of inertia value for the y direction. So consider this particular triangle again along the y direction. When I consider along the y direction, I need to consider the variable along the x direction. So consider a triangle again of base width b and height h, thickness of this particular strip as dx and height as h1. If I consider this particular triangular rectangular strip from the origin as x, remaining left out distance will be b minus of x, whole distance is b, and the other left out part will be b minus of x. Applying the principle of similar triangle, why we need to apply principle of similar triangle here is, this rectangular strip what we have considered, and at any distance x, the height of that particular rectangular strip is h1. When the same strip coincides with respect to the vertical axis, h1 will be converted as h, that is h1 will be equals to h. Same h1, when it touches to the tip of the triangle, h1 will be equated to 0. So for that reason, we need to express h1 in terms of the constant terms, either in terms of h or b. So I apply principle of similar triangle, which is h by b, that is height of the bigger triangle divided by the base of the bigger triangle, is equal to h1 divided by b minus of x. H1 will be equals to h by b, b minus of x. Area of the elemental strip will be h1 into dx, that is height of the rectangle multiplied by the width of the rectangle. Width of the rectangle is dx. dA is equal to h by b, b minus of x into dx. This is what is the area of the elemental strip. Since x is a variable here and x is perpendicular to y axis, so moment of inertia shall be considered as y. Earlier expression, if you look back at the earlier expression, y is a variable and y is perpendicular to x, so you express it as ixx is equal to integration y square dA. Then here x is a variable, so x is perpendicular to yxx, iyy. X is perpendicular to y axis, so iyy is equal to integration x square dA. Substitute the term to find out all the values here. When I substitute, x square is a variable kept as it is. Substitute the value of dA. After substitution, the value of bA, it shall be h by b, b minus of x, dx. As x is a variable, I need to substitute the limits of x. Limits of x, when it reaches to the origin, it will be 0. When it reaches to the tip of the triangle, it will be b. So limits of x will be 0 to b. So take h by b outside, and what is left out here is 0 to b, b x square. First term, when x square goes within the bracket, it will be b x square. Second term, it will be x cube. So b x square minus x cube dx, which is iyy. H by b, keep it as it is. Now integration of x square will be b into x cube by 3. Integration of x cube will be x raised to 4 divided by 4, 0 to b. Substitute the limits here. When I substitute the limits, first limit will be b cube into b will raise to b to the power of 4 divided by 3. Similarly, next term will be b raised to 4 divided by 4. Then the next limit when I substitute, it will be 0 minus of 0. Iyy. So Iyy will be h by b kept as it is, 4 b raised to 4 minus 3 b raised to 4 divided by 3 into 4 in the denominator. 4 minus 3 will come as 1, so h by b 12, 4 minus 3 will be 1, b raised to 4 divided by 12, 3 into 4 will come as 12. B in the denominator, b to the power of 4 in the numerator will get cancelled up. So I y y expression can be expressed as I y y is equal to h b cube divided by 12, or else b cube h divided by 12 will be the expression for I y y. If you look back for I x x, it was b h cube by 12, and here it is b cube h divided by 12. Reason: for y axis base is perpendicular, for x axis height is perpendicular. So whichever side is perpendicular to an axis, that particular side will have the highest power. So that's the reason why here it is b cube h divided by 12. Further, we need to find out I y g. Now what we have calculated here is, or what we have evaluated here is the value of I y y. If I consider a triangle here, the value of I y y is b cube h divided by 12. Apart from that, I also have one more axis which passes through the centroid, and that particular axis is called as yg. I need to find out the value of yg. To find out the value of yg, I will be making use of parallel axis theorem. As yy and yg are both parallel to each other, I shall make use of parallel axis theorem. And parallel axis theorem states is iyy is equal to iyg plus of a into h square, where h is the perpendicular distance between yy and yg. H is the perpendicular distance between yy and yg. Earlier it was ixx is equal to ixg plus a into h square. Now this h, what we had expressed earlier, is the perpendicular distance between xx and xg. Now what we are going to consider is the perpendicular distance between yy and yg. If I consider a triangle here, yy axis is placed towards the left hand side, yg axis is passing towards the centroid, and distance between both is b by 3. So h value is b by 3 that we are going to consider. Earlier it was h value was considered as h by 3 because it's the distance between xx and xg. If I substitute the value, iyy value what we have calculated was b cube h divided by 12. Substitute the same value here as b cube h divided by 12 is equal to iyg plus area of the triangle as half base into height, and h value is b by 3 whole square. Resolving this particular expression, iyg will be equals to b cube h divided by 12 minus of b, h has been kept as it is, h square divided by 2 into 9. Simplifying this, b cube h divided by 12 minus of b, h into h square will come out to h cube. In the denominator it will be 2 into 9 is 18. Solving this, 18 minus of 12 b cube h divided by 12 into 18, b cube h 12 into 18. 18 minus of 12 will be 6, b cube h divided by 12 into 18. 6 ones are 62, b cube h divided by 2 into 18 will come as 36, 2 into 18 shall come as 36, which is the value of iyg. And value of ixg was b h cube divided by 36. It is the reverse whenever we consider the expression for ixg and iyg. If I redraw this particular section, ixg value is b h cube by 36 because h is perpendicular to x, and iyg value is b cube h divided by 36. So we need to carefully substitute the value of ixg and iyg whenever we consider the moment of inertia along x and y direction. So when we consider moment of inertia along x direction, we need to consider as b h cube by 36. When I consider moment of inertia along y direction, it is b cube h divided by 36. This is how we are supposed to find out the moment of inertia for a triangular section from the first principle. So from first principle, it is ixx is equal to integration y square dA, and iyy is equal to integration x square dA. Further, we need to substitute the value of the elemental area dA and x and y term, which is nothing but the centroidal distance for the both the axes which are parallel to each other. So since they are parallel to each other, we'll make use of parallel axis theorem to find out the moment of inertia along a corresponding section. Thank you. Have a nice day.